based out of our North Carolina office. I'm just going to talk to you a little bit about our growing internship program. I want to give you some information about who we are, what we look for, and how you can best engage in a dialogue with us and help your students. So, So I thought I'd start by introducing last year's class. So these were the guys and gals. Oh, it's actually all guys and anyway, who made up our class of 2017 at our headquarters, which is primarily where the internship program is based. Not exclusively, but primarily right now, largely because I'm only one person. also because this is where about 400 of EPIC's 700 global employees are located. So that number seems to increase by the day, so forgive me if that's wrong. what most people want to know is, great, so how many of those people turned into employees? Hey guys! So here is the either employees or contractors that remained on or re-engaged with us after the internship program. And these are the schools that they came from. I wanted to give a special shout out to the universities and places we have relationships with, and all the hard work that these guys did together with you. So we tend to be pretty picky. And I'll tell you a little bit, like I said, about what specifically we're looking for and how that evolves over time, and then what characteristics we find make students successful in internships at EPIC. Here's a little overview of the program. So what it is we time box it, so it's June to September only right now, and it's primarily located in Cary, North Carolina. We have one or two people in Bellevue and then also in Guilford. So this is going to continue to expand. We'll talk a little bit about this. So this is actually only the fourth year of EPIC's internship program. I know Brian Brock started as an intern back when, but since I've joined, we decided to actually create a program rather than, hey, that person's a little too young, hires a full-time employee, let's call them an intern and get them in there and see what they're capable of, which was a little bit more of our process previously. So they are really, they're vetted as any other employee is vetted through an internship process or portfolio reviews, things along those lines. And then they're invited into the team to work on features. They are not given internship level tasks, whatever that means. For us, they're invited on to be a developer and to be a part of the team. We don't restrict the levels of students. We've primarily seen that most of our, over the few years that we have had this program, most of the interns have tended to be either recent graduates, master's students, or in their, probably like senior year of their education. And I think that there's a few reasons for this. One is because it was still kind of new for EPIC to bring people on right out of school. And so the more senior I think that people were, the more work experience, internship experience, the more specialized they were, the more comfortable people felt really inviting them in. Because if you think about it, you know, what you're doing is you're taking leads, you're taking technical leads, people who maybe have only been managing other human beings in any capacity in addition to contributing work, and you're saying, great, here's a student who maybe has never had a job. Go ahead, have fun. You know what to do, right? You got this? So it's been a real learning process for all of us, and we want to make sure that when people are walking in, they can come in and they have something that they're able to ideas about what it is they want to accomplish, as well as being open to where EPIC takes them. So we do provide professional development and team building events. That means that they get to spend a lot of time with me, get to do baseball games, to go bowling, you know, stuff like that. But we also set up lunch and learns where they get exposure to developers across the company and understand a bit more about what other disciplines are doing. But yeah, hands-on experience, working directly with the engine. So the 2018 internship lists look a little sparse, and I'm going to tell you why. Fortnite. Primarily. So some of these have been posted on our website. We'll talk a little bit more about the application process. We are not actively accepting applicants through our website any longer for our summer months. As you know, we're getting a little close. Does that mean that I don't want to hear about the great students that you have to refer, or that there's no chance that anybody else could join the team? No, absolutely not. We're still open to that conversation, and if you've got great students you want to recommend, please, I'll talk to you a little bit later in the slide about how to do that. But right now what we've tried to do, or at least what I've sort of tried to contain some of the madness by making sure that anybody who joins the teams at an intern level is joining a team that isn't maybe in as much of a hyper shit mode as Battle Royale is. So that's why you've noticed that there's probably not a lot of like, game design or, you know, game art roles up right now, because as those teams are gelling and shipping content all the time, I want to make sure that we've got enough space and time and energy to really devote to making sure that your interns have a good experience. We had a great experience last year where we had two design interns, and we hit content lock during their first like 6-8 weeks of the internship. So that was an exciting experience for them. We're like, great, you're a game designer, we're in content lock, so if you could just play a lot of Fortnite, that would be great. We've made better use of them than that, obviously, and I think that they still had a good experience. One of them is actually still contracting with the team. But just give you a sense for how many different types of things we're trying to juggle as we do ship products regularly as part of a small team, but also want to remain passionate about working with you guys and your students. So looking ahead, I want to be completely transparent with you guys about where we're headed. So right now, I am part of a team of about 4 or 5 recruiters who work for across our global studios. Okay, there's much more help than that at the different locations that we do have, but dedicated to hiring for the engine team and all of the content creation teams and things along those lines, down to finance people, you name it, right? We cover all of it. And what we're ready to do is we're really ready to give dedicated recruiting support to our university relations group. So we are now posting for a university relations recruiter. This is going to be somebody using getting an internship, but I think it's hard to try joining as a university relations recruiter. We are ruthless. we're looking for people who have worked in similar companies and really built programs from the ground up so that you guys will have access to people who will regularly be available to come speak, be a resource for you, work closely with our education program, leverage our academic partnerships, and through that, build stronger on-campus presence and add strong, repeatable internships to our offices, such as Montreal, Salt Lake City, growing offices in Europe, and hopefully some of our China and Korea offices as well. And Japan hasn't mentioned anything yet, but I wouldn't put it past. So we'll see. I'd like to sign my future coworker up for a lot of exciting opportunities. So if there's anything else you think he or she should be doing, let me know. But let's get back to what we can do today. So today I want to talk to you a little bit about how to survive the internship battle royale, right? You do your best to prepare students and then throw them out into the world. And what I can tell you is not about what you can do to make them universally acceptable to all jobs everywhere, but I can talk to you a little bit about what EPIC specifically is looking for. So keep that in mind as we go through our conversation, right? This is mostly about where EPIC is today and what we're looking for. So our application process, we require a portfolio, we require code samples, we require survey responses adhering like a production internship type of position. So no matter what it is that you're doing, show us. That's key, right? The difference between a student and a professional is really the work. So show us their professional level of work. And they always want to know, if I don't have the experience, how do I get a job? And it's like, well, what are you doing, right? People at EPIC are naturally curious. They're naturally motivated to make something and to do. And so what we want to see is people who are in the early stages of their career to share that passion and express it in that same way. Resume, keep it simple. I can't emphasize this enough. Keep it simple. we're looking for clean information on that, contact information, web links. We'll talk a little bit more about that in detail, but resume and portfolio requirements. We don't require a cover letter. That's really reserved for a conversation. We want to let the work talk for itself. The process is that the applications are accepted through the website or through direct referrals, but we do try to collect everything through the website so that we can track it easily and make sure that people are getting the level of communication that they need. Selections are generally made by or in April, and all of our applicants receive a response. They don't receive a response right away, necessarily. Usually, once those positions have been filled, and sometimes that can be months after the applications start coming in. So, but everybody at some point will get that acknowledgement that both they get the acknowledgement right away that their application has been received, and we do try to follow up with every single one of them. So, what we look for, again, if you're looking for an online portfolio, this should be the best work. Anybody who's heard me talk about the best work process, right? It's like, if you show us strong work and you show us weak work, we assume you don't know the difference. So, always it's about showcasing where you are today and what you are most proud of. We assume that if you are good at a thing, that you are once less good at a thing, so you don't need to prove that to us. And also, this seems simple, but if you could put, you know, always encourage students to just make it easy for the recruiter to get access to what's important to them. So things like putting a link to that portfolio or that reel or whatever it is on your resume so that I'm not hunting around in 3 or 4 places to find things is always really helpful to my communication with my hiring managers as well. The clean resume that shows what you've done at school and maybe the jobs you've held. I don't need people to go into too much depth about the jobs they've held, but I'll tell you why this is relevant to me personally and to what I found as successful at Epic. Is it's nice to know that somebody had to be, you know, paid for a job once, that they knew about what it meant to show up on time and be a part of a team. And so it's not a requirement, but it's nice to know, right? It's nice to know, like, yeah, actually I worked in the school library, or I was a teaching assistant, or I worked at Chili's during the summers, whatever it is. It's don't be afraid of who you are and what you've done, but showcase what it is that we're looking for. Side projects and passion projects. If you think that they're valuable or if they're interesting, if you build robots on the side and compete in, you know, cooking classes or whatever it is, feel free to put that on there as well, because depending on what we're looking for and the projects that we've either announced or haven't announced, these things may become relevant. So share with us the things that you are proud of and what you're doing. And also, we look for a passion in an area of focus. So you just listened to two people who cover a pretty broad range of skills and interests. When we are looking for interns who are in tools development, graphics programming, or game design, or particularly, say, effects art, something along those lines, what we're really looking for is somebody that we can point at that thing, and they're going to be hungry to sit in that discipline and apply all the things that they have learned. I get a lot of resumes for, say, production assistant, and at the top of it will say, producer, environment artist, game designer, programmer, and I was like, ooh, you know, like, what do you want to be when you grow up? Like, let's focus, right? Like, we're trying to solve, we need people in there who are like, producers, great, you're passionate about project management, you're passionate about seeing the team succeed, you're detail-oriented, you're not going to get bored if you're not creating content. Like, these are things that are important for me to know so that I can say, hey, this person is actually really passionate about effects art, and you can see that reflected in their portfolio. So finding an area of focus, I think if you could help your students express that area of focus as they apply to jobs, that would be really helpful for Epic. Because we do tend to look for people who have like a standout area. And in the portfolio, understanding what we're looking for, right? So if students actually read the job description, and I know that that feels like a lot of work for most people. Like, I'd rather just blanket apply and let you tell me what I'm qualified for. We can do that too. But it's really helpful if they understand what we're looking for and they show us that they understand that, right? If you're applying for a role on Fortnite in, say, environment art or something along those lines, show us that you understand what it means to create stylized characters, or if you're looking at a certain type of like tools programming position, help us understand that you understand what it means to build a tool, that you want to work in the editor, that you're not like, well, I'll apply to tools, but I really want to be a graphics programmer. It's like, no, if you want to be a graphics programmer, go learn about rendering you guys and stuff like that. To us. we want people who are going to just attack whatever it is that they are excited about, and we try to show you, hey, here's the problem that we need to solve. Can you help us solve that problem? And if you say yes, show us that in your portfolio. Does that make sense? Okay. Anyway, so you've absorbed all this, now you understand what we're looking for, how to do it, and you're like, great, I have a great student I want to recommend. At least I hope that's what you're thinking. So in the event that you have a great student that you want to recommend, so my cards will be readily available. I will be, along with a lot of our recruiting team, at our booth on the show floor. We'll be at that games, jobs part, beer, probably less so on the beer part. But we'll be at the jobs part of that all week. So student day, I think it's Friday, I'll be there just ready to shake hands and meet people. We're not going to accept paper resumes, but we are happy to receive introductions and get faces to connect to some of the names and applications we've had in the past. And over time, if you're interested in not recommending somebody today, but how do we build a relationship with EDIC to make sure that when these students do emerge, there's a place to send them? Right now, the best place to send them is just email me, right? Let's start that conversation. Let's figure out how do we build something that is keeps you connected to what EDIC is doing and keeps us connected to what's happening in your programs. The more information I have about what's important to your school, and what's important to your students and what's important to you, the better I know how to engage with you. And so let's figure out how we can start those conversations, and just knowing that one day you'll have to deal with somebody who's probably far more talented and has much more time than I do. but EDIC is really passionate, as you can tell, right, about making sure that we can have an effective dialogue about how we connect amazing emerging talent to real world jobs. So email me, find me at the booth, and let's see where we can start. But in the meantime, too, here are some other ways you can help your students. Knowing what's happening in the industry, including just what tools and company activities happening, right? Staying up to date, passing that information on to students, teaching them how to get that information is, I find, really, really valuable, right? I still have students apply and say, I want to work on the Gears of War team. You know, so understanding who you're in a conversation with, you know, can help you be set up for success. Teaching best practices about applying for jobs, right? Helping people apply to things that they are qualified for. Applying to the, rendering programmer internship and the creative services art director job, right? Probably not going to be your best foot forward. So teaching them about the fact that all of those things matter. And networking, early, often, even while you're still in school. I have so many amazing success stories of people who, you know, started a conversation either at GDC or in an on-campus talk, and they weren't quite ready for anything, but over time we kept in touch. I still have people that I met for 15 minutes 5 years ago who are still sending me updates to their portfolios. And maybe I don't have something for them, but man, isn't it fun to connect them over to someplace else or make a referral. So teach them about how to really effectively build those relationships, not only with recruiters, but with other developers, with people that they're excited about meeting, right? There's one of the beautiful things about the industry is just that you can contact your heroes, right? They're accessible in places like this. So teaching them about the value of making those connections. Attending this event, yay, thank you for being here. And keep inspiring great people and great work. I know that what you guys do is really emotionally and intellectually challenging, and I just want to let you know how grateful we are that you continue to do it every day. So this is us, and I realize this is the first slide deck I've put together in probably 5 years without a meme, so I just apologize for that. I'm really sorry, guys. But yeah, find us, that's our career site. Follow us on the social medias, find us on Facebook.